what I assume, you should assume. For every atom belonging to me, as good belongs to you. I loaf and bite my soul. I lean and loaf at my ease, observing a sphere of summer breath. Houses and rooms are full of perfumes. The shelves are crowded with perfumes. I breathe the fragrance myself, and know it and like it. The distillation would intoxicate me also, but I shall not let it. The atmosphere is not a perfume. It has no taste of the distillation. It is odorless. It is for my mouth forever. I am in love with it. I will go to the bank by the wood and become undisguised and naked. I am mad for it to be in contact with me. The smoke of my own breath echoes, ripples, buzzed whispers, love root, silk thread, crutch and vine, my respiration and inspiration, the beating of my heart, the passing of blood and air through my lungs, the sniff of green leaves and dry leaves, and of the shorn and dark-coloured sea rocks, and of hay in the barn, the sound of the belched words of my voice loose to the eddies of the wind, a few light kisses, a few embraces, a reaching around of arms, the play of shine and shade on the trees as the supple boughs wag, the dying light alone, or in the rush of the streets, or along the fields and hillsides, the feeling of health, the full moon trill, the song of me rising from bed and meeting the sun. Shore is the most certain shore, plumb in the uprights, well entreated, braced in the beams, stout as a horse, affectionate, haughty, electrical. I and this mystery, here we stand. Clear and sweet is my soul, and clear and sweet is all that is not my soul. Loaf with me on the grass. Loose the stop from your throat. Not words, not music or rhyme I want. Not custom or lecture, not even the best. Only the lull I like, the hum of your valved voice. I mind how once we lay such a transparent summer morning, how you settled your head athwart my hips and gently turned over upon me and parted the shirt from my bosom bone and plunged your tongue to my bare straight thighs and reached till you felt my beard and reached till you held my feet. Thank you. beat by ease. What is a man anyhow? What am I? Who are you? One thing more than another, it shall be the spread of my own body, or any part of it. Translucent mould of me, it shall be you. Shaded ledges and rests, it shall be you. Firm masculine coulter, it shall be you. Whatever goes to the tilth of me, it shall be you. You, my rich blood, your milky stream, pale strippings of my life. Breast that presses against other breasts, it shall be you. My brain, it shall be your occult convolutions. Root of washed sweet flag, timorous pond snipe, nest of guarded duplicate eggs, it shall be you. Mixed tousled hay of head, beard, brawn, it shall be you. Trickling sap of maple, fibre of manly wheat, it shall be you. Sun so generous, it shall be you. Vapours lighting and shading my face, it shall be you. You sweaty brooks and dews, it shall be you. Winds whose soft tickling genitals rub against me, it shall be you. Broad muscular fields, branches of live oak, loving lounger in my winding paths, it shall be you. Hands I have taken, face I have kissed, mortal I have ever touched, it shall be you. Quivering me to a new identity. Flames and ether making a rush for my veins. Treacherous tickle me, reaching and crowding to help them. My flesh and blood playing out lightning to strike what is hardly different from myself. On all sides, prurient provokers stiffening my limbs, straining the udder of my heart for its withheld drip. Behaving licentious towards me, taking no denial, depriving me of my best as for a purpose, unbuttoning my clothes, holding me by the bare waist, deluding my confusion with the calm of the sunlight and pasture fields, immodestly sliding the fellow senses away, they bribed to swap off with touch and go and graze at the edges of me. What I guessed at when I loafed on the grass, what I guessed while I lay alone in my bed, and again as I walked the beach under the paling stars of the morning. Thank you. into the unknown. The clock indicates the moment, but what does eternity indicate? About each, I'm not curious about God. No array of terms can say how much I'm at peace about God and about death. I hear and behold God in every object, yet understand God not in the least. Nor do I understand who there can be more wonderful than myself. Why should I wish to see God better than this day? I see something of God each hour of the 24 and each moment. In the faces of men and women, I see God. And in my own face in the glass, I find letters from God dropped in the street. And every one is signed by God's name. And I leave them where they are. For I know that wheresoever I go, others will punctually come. It is without name. It is a word unsaid. It is not in any dictionary, utterance, or symbol. Do I contradict myself? Very well then, I contradict myself. I am large. I contain multitudes. Who has done his day's work? Who will soonest be through with his supper? Who wishes to walk with me? Will you speak before I am gone? Will you prove already too late? part as air. I shake my white locks at the runaway sun. I effuse my flesh in eddies and drift it in lacy jags. I bequeath myself to the dirt, to grow from the grass I love. If you want me again, look for me under your boot soles. You will hardly know who I am, or what I need, but I shall be good health to you nevertheless, and filter and fibre your blood. Failing to fetch me first, keep encouraged. Missing me one place, search another. I'll stop somewhere, waiting for you.